Populations are aging and shrinking across economies globally. What started as a talent shortage in a few countries will continue to devolve into an outright shortage of workers across the globe. I'm so excited to be here. This is an oat milk latte. Very much needed. It's a beverage of your choice.
Yeah. With Lightcast.
Are we rolling? Marker. I'm Elizabeth. And today we're discussing the global demographic drought. Here's a jolt to wake you up if you're a leader in a multinational company. The global labor shortage is showing no signs of slowing down, but the milk and sugar to offset the jolt is that you're not a hostage to these changes. There are practical ways you can meet this challenge. Lightcast reports have documented the imminent demographic drought in the US. But this isn't just about the US. At the same time, the populations in Asian and Latin American countries will slow down twice as fast through 2040 as in the US. And in the European Union, where populations are flat out declining, almost 30% of manufacturing and services firms reported that a lack of workers limited production in the second quarter of 2022. I do need a coffee break. I need a jolt to keep going. All right. For global business leaders, there are three factors to watch. First, an aging population is happening everywhere, but at a different pace. Today, countries in Europe and East Asia are aging fastest. Through 2040, the working age population is expected to slow in 9 out of 10 countries globally and to outright shrink in 3 out of 10. Second, falling immigration will further squeeze the labor supply in more developed economies. Net migration is projected to fall in 60% of developed economies over the next 20 years, according to the United Nations. Immigration in North America is expected to slow down, but not enough to cause working age population to decline. In Europe, the situation is more dire. The population is projected to lose more workers than immigration will replace. And third, higher workforce participation can partially offset the smaller number of working age people, so it's not all doom and gloom. Over the last decade, labor force growth has outpaced working age population growth in 4 out of 10 countries, a trend primarily seen in developed economies in North America, Europe, Oceania, and East Asia. Increasing the size of the labor force by tapping into new talent pools is one way employers can get the workers they need. Where's my coffee? The gloves. Where's my coffee? Marker. So what does this all mean for employers? The global demographic drought will not constrain employers to the same extent everywhere. Certain geographies will fare better than others, depending on three things. Here's what employers need to know. One. There's a lot you as an employer can do to get more people into the workforce. Flexible work, skill-based hiring, and making accommodations for health or family challenges can tap into overlooked talent and partially offset the economic impact of a declining labor supply. Two, businesses need to understand the skills, tech readiness, and innovative capacity of the local workforce. Companies can more successfully compensate for a shortage of workers if the workers that are available are highly skilled, have access to new technologies, and can operate in a dynamic and innovative environment. And three, employers really need to value the workers they have. Employers are finding out that workers aren't disposable, and employees who leave may not be so easy to replace. You're in a competitive labor market, and you need to make sure you're building a company where people want to work. At Lightcast, our global data sets and expertise in international labor markets can shed light on the combination of skills, technology, and people that are available in each global region. Our insights can help inform employers of the recruitment strategies most likely to succeed in their geographies. Visit this link to learn more about the demographic risks and opportunities that will drive your global talent acquisition strategy. I'm Elizabeth. Thank you for joining me. May you remain well caffeinated.